Hey, this is Dr. Avinash from Pulse Tutorials, Mumbai, and we are super excited to share this video with you. This mastery session is all about introduction to orthopedic examination. Let's set up the tone for your examination. Start by washing your hands with soap before and also after you have finished the examination. As the patient walks in, observe the gait of the patient. This will definitely help you in your diagnosis. Introduce yourself to your patient. And fourth, ensure adequate exposure of the patient while respecting patient's modesty. This should set up a nice tone for your clinical examination. We follow the 6 steps to perfect examination in orthopedics. Step number 1 would be inspection, where you see. Step 2 is palpation, where you touch. Step 3 is assessment of range of motion. Step 4 would be assessing the power of the muscles involved. Step number 5 would be the neurovascular examination, and step 6 would be special test, if any, for that particular part. Let us elaborate on every single topic here. The first step is inspection. Remember the mnemonic SEADS, SEADS, for swelling, erythema, atrophy, deformities, scars, skin changes, sinuses, etc. When you are describing this, please give the exact location. You might use bony landmarks and give the measurements from the bony landmarks. Never forget to compare with the contralateral side. Your history should corroborate with the scars and sinuses that the patient has on his or her limbs. And always examine the joint above and the joint below, the part you are examining. This will help you in reaching a nice diagnosis without making much of a mistake. Step 2 is palpation. Remember, test CA. Tenderness, any effusion, swellings, temperature, crepitus, and atrophy of the muscle. Here the atrophy, you are going to measure it. Always compare with the contralateral side. Include the joint above and the joint below as you are examining the part. All the distances of your tenderness, effusions, and swellings should be measured from any bony landmark. And never forget to do the fluctuation test and the transillumination test for swellings. Step number 3. The third point of examination is measuring the range of motion. For this, we require an instrument called as the goniometer. Each goniometer has 2 arms, the stationary arm and the moving arm. The stationary arm should always be on the proximal bone or for joint, and the moving arm should be on the distal part. And always note your findings in degrees of movements as compared from the standard resting position. Now, there are 2 ways of assessing range of motion: active and passive. Active is when the patient moves their limbs by themselves. Passive is when we, the doctors, move the limb of the patient. Always do the active first, then the passive. Now, when you're doing passive range of motion, assess the end feel. If the end feel is bony, suggest a bony pathology like osteoarthritis or a fracture. But if the end feel is soft, it generally indicates a soft tissue pathology, like the problem might be in a joint capsule or ligaments or tendons or muscles. It will aid you in your differential diagnosis. Note the range of motion in degrees of movement from the standard position. Here I am giving you range of motion of certain important joints. The shoulder joint, flexion is 0 to 180 degree. Extension is 0 to 60 degree. Abduction is 180 degree. Medial rotation is 0 to 70 degree. And lateral rotation is 0 to 90 degree. At the elbow joint, only 2 movements are possible: flexion, 0 to 150 degree. A fully extended elbow does not undergo hyperextension, so the range of movement of extension is 0. Wrist joint has 4 movements: flexion, 0 to 80 degree, extension, 0 to 70 degree, radial deviation, 0 to 20 degree, and ulnar deviation, 0 to 30 degree. Hip joint has 6 important movements: flexion, 0 to 120 degree, hyperextension, 0 to 30 degree, abduction, 0 to 45 degree, adduction, 0 to 30 degree, medial rotation, 0 to 45 degree, and lateral rotation is also 0 to 45 degree. The knee joint, only two movements, flexion and extension. From the standard resting position, that is a fully extended leg, flexion is 0 to 135 degree. There can be no hyperextension possible at the knee joint. The ankle joint has four movements, dorsiflexion of around 0 to 20 degree, plantar flexion of 0 to 30 degree, inversion of 0 to 35 degree, and eversion of 0 to 15 degree. Once we are done with the range of motion, we move on to the next topic of our examination, which is power. Ideally, we are supposed to do resisted isometric testing, in which we make the joint in a particular position and then we apply the force and ask the patient to resist. We grade it into six grades: 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Grade 0 is no muscle contraction. Grade 1 is slight contraction of muscle but not adequate for any joint movement. 2 is movements of body part with gravity eliminated. That's when you are supporting it. Grade 3 is movement against gravity only. Grade 4, movements of body part against gravity and some moderate resistance. While grade 5 is movement against gravity with full resistance. The next step is neurological and vascular assessment. Here we check the pulse and the capillary refill time, power, reflexes, sensations, and tone. Do not forget to measure the pulse and the capillary refill time on both the limbs. Compare the power on both the limbs as described above. Do the reflexes bilaterally. The sensations have to be determined dermatomally. And measure the tone on both the sides. This should give you a complete assessment of the status of this patient. This should be followed by any specific test that has to be done according to the part tested. I just love this idea of new web series for ortho examination. Thank you so much for watching this. It's been a pleasure talking to you all today. Don't forget to leave a comment, subscribe, like us, and share us on Facebook. Never give up on your dreams. Keep moving forward towards them. And I really hope this video has helped you a lot today. Have an amazing week, and I'll talk to you soon in our channel.